This is Ben Faruqi for Boxing Social in association with Betfred. I'm here with the one and only Callum Smith. Callum, how are you doing today, mate?
Yeah, I'm good, mate. How are you?
I'm good. Just had your media workout there. I spend a lot of time in the gym, and you always strike me as the quieter of the Smith brothers. So, I take it these things aren't the easiest for you when everyone's you're the focus.
Yeah, listen, I don't enjoy all this hard work, public workouts, press conferences. I understand that it's something that needs to be done, but I'm quite outside
the minute. You're the introvert of the family.
Yeah, but they have to be done, and I'm getting a little bit better.
How do you find that sort of in terms of being a boxer, and you have to sort of almost make a name for yourself now? You have to scream and shout sometimes to get fights. Do you think it's affected you at all in your career?
Probably. Listen, my profile probably could be bigger than what it is, but I've always just felt that, and I think I'm probably proof to other fighters turning professional, that you don't have to argue at press conferences, you don't have to shout and call every man the dog out, you don't have to create this character to self fights. I think if you're good enough and you keep winning and you keep performing and make people want to watch you because you're exciting, then you'll get to wherever you want to be. And it's not being the number one in the world by doing it my way, just performing in the ring. And because I've never had a bad bluff fight, I've never argued, I've never done anything like that, and I've achieved what I wanted to. So listen, obviously it helps in terms of profiles. Fighters have probably got fights and earned money that the ability didn't deserve, but they were a bigger name because of social media, because of the build to fight. But I've always just felt that I've done it my way, and I think if I was to start doing that now, it'd be so out of character that people wouldn't buy into it.
Yeah. Fighting John Ryder on the 23rd. Tell me about camp. How's camp gone?
Camp's gone well. It's been good. The gym's been busy, there's other fighters fighting similar times, obviously Crawler last weekend, and that's the way I like it. The gym's busy, we always push each other, we always make it that little bit better to come to the gym when you know other people are there doing the same thing as you, and this camp's been no different. It's been busy, it's been good, but I've got good working with Joe and I feel we're improving.
Obviously, with it being Crawler's last fight, it must have been quite an emotional thing. Has that played on the camp at all, affected it in any way?
No, it's just been, listen, it's been good to train alongside him. He had a good camp, and he's someone I've always liked training. I've always liked training alongside. He's a true professional. He does everything right. And as a fighter turned professional, he was good to learn from. And he showed me that to reach the top, you've got to live a good life. And listen, he's not the most naturally gifted, but he's maximised his potential by just being a true professional and doing everything correct. And listen, he's a good role model to look up to, not just for myself, but for anyone else turning professional.
John Ryder wasn't perhaps your first pick when you were looking for this fight.
Yeah.
Has that sort of affected your motivation in any way going forward for the fight?
No, listen, obviously it's nice when you get mentioned alongside your Canelos and your Golovkins and them fighters, but a mandatory is a mandatory, and them fights, the big names are still there, but I've got to win November 23rd, so listen, this fight I must win more than ever, and I'm only going to get the fight to Canelo's as a world champion, and I lose to John Ryder and all that disappears. So it's a big opportunity for him. I've got to expect the best version of him, but the best version of me beats anyone in the world at 168.
Do you think it's important for you to make a statement in Liverpool and get the Liverpool fans really riled up for the idea of having an Anfield fight next year?
Yeah, I think so. Listen, the performance is always important to me. The win's the main thing, but I always like to perform and make people come away and not just talk about the win, but talk about the performance and say, listen, he is the man to go and beat or whatever. And the performance has always been a big factor for me, and especially now fighting in Liverpool for the first time in a couple of years. I don't want to go in and stink the place out, and it's my first time fighting there as a world champion. So, listen, there is pressure, but I've always feel I've performed better under pressure. It's one of my biggest nights and my biggest tests. I've always, where I've produced the best performances, and I feel this one will be no different.
Without overlooking John Ryder, going forward, if you were to get that Anfield fight, you've got like Caleb Plant with the IBF, you've got Billy Joe, WBO, you've got Canelo, who's got the WBA regular. Who else have we got?
Benavidez.
So, out of those, what's your top pick?
Listen, obviously Canelo, not for the WBA regular, but just he's the name in boxing, he's the superstar, and I think there's a massive queue to get a fight with him. But it's an outside of him, there's a lot of other top fighters, the three you just named, the title holders, they're all unbeaten. I'm unbeaten myself, so fight with each other, regardless of what way you make them, is a good fight. They're exciting fights, and unification fight is sort of the goal where I've set myself and what I want to achieve in 2020. So it's an ambi on the phone to Eddie to try and deliver me one of their names next year. And the top fighters, but the fighters I believe I beat.
Do you think Billy Joe's arguably the easiest one for you to make out?
I think so, yeah, because we're both under the matching banner. I think the other two are PBC, which obviously complicates things a slight bit, but the Billy Joe one should be pretty simple to make.
Do you think it's the trickiest out of those for you?
Trickiest, probably, yeah, stylistically, but then there's other, like, they all have strengths in different ways. Benavidez is probably a much bigger puncher, but isn't as slick and mover. They've all got different styles, but they've all got world titles, and I'd take either of them. There's no preference in which one of those three I can fight. It's just I want big fights. I want fights that motivate me, and them three definitely do.
Will you be keeping one eye on how Billy Joe performs this weekend?
Yeah and no, because I think he'll perform well, because I don't think the opponent much. I've never seen him, but I've seen his record, and he doesn't look the best, but as soon as he can come through his fight and I can come through mine, then I think a possible fight next year is a massive fight for Britain.
Carl Frampton said recently in an interview that he felt George Groves quit against you. What did you make of that comment?
I don't know. I think they've got their own little problems, and they're probably having little digs at each other. I think they blocked each other or something, someone was saying. But it's a tough one. I've never come out and said he quit. I wouldn't say any fighter quit, especially off a body shot. You give a little bit more leeway. I said at the time, I think probably could have got up. But a lot of fighters can't. It's getting up and fighting, which is the hard thing. But it's not, I wouldn't label him a quitter, because he's had a tough career. He's come back from no other stuff, and you can never question his heart and his balls, so to speak. But yeah, I think that was just, they must have their own little.
Okay, finally, Anthony Crawler last weekend, his final fight. How was it for you emotionally, being his stable mate and training with him?
Yeah, listen, it was always going to be a big night. And I said before, it doesn't really feel much different now, because even if he was still fighting, he'd be out the gym now anyway, because he's just boxed, so he'd have been a couple of weeks off. I think it's when he's due back in camp and he's not back in, that's when he'll start to feel the gym's quiet without him, because he is a big part of the gym. He's a big character, and I think he's been here the longest. So listen, he is a big part of the gym, and he's someone I've always enjoyed training with. But he had a great career. He achieved everything, and I'm sure he can retire happy and content with what he did achieve.
You guys are obviously very close-knit here. You're like a family. When you lose someone like that, how does it affect you all?
Yeah, listen, like I said, the gym would be a big hole, and he was a big character in the gym. But knowing Crawler and knowing his lifestyle, I think he'll be in and out the gym.
Popping in all the time.
Yeah, boxing's a big part of his life, and I think he said he wants to stay involved in boxing in some way. So I think he'll always be in and out the gym. And like I said, I class him as a friend as well as a gym mate, so I think we'll still keep in touch.
There was a number of people online, and Matthew Mackley included, who thought he lost the fight on Saturday. What did you think of the scorecards?
It was very close, to be honest with you. I thought some 5-0 was probably a good shout, maybe 6-4 Crawler. You could argue 6-4 the opponent. It was a close fight. It wasn't the best performance from Crawler, and I think he kind of just cemented his reason to retire. I think a couple of years ago he'd went through that kid and probably took him out. So it was probably a blessing in that sense, as in it's probably given himself closure. But listen, I thought he'd done enough late on to probably just nick it, but it was a close fight. I think it was more the scorecards would have.
There was one wide one, wasn't it?
Yeah, 1-8-2 to Crawler, which was never that score. But listen, I thought he had a terrible start, but I thought he pulled it back late on.
Finally, could you go into your last fight knowing it was your last fight, or would you find it harder knowing that you've got to train through that camp and knowing that you're going to quit?
See, I don't know. It's hard to. Unless you're in that position, it's hard to know whether you'd be able to motivate yourself knowing that nothing's going to come of it if you do win, and nothing's going to come after it. It was just your last one. So I don't know. I think, but listen, he had a very good camp. His performance didn't reflect the camp he had. He had a really good camp. He sparred really well as well. So it's just one of them things on the night. He just didn't perform, whether it was a bad performance or whether he is that little bit past it. I don't know. But I think he's going to retire happy. He had a very good career.
Will you be staying up to watch KSI on the weekend?
No, I'll be getting my sleeve. I might watch it in the morning or something. But listen, there's a lot of interest around it. I see both sides of the arguments, but listen, good on them. I hope it's a good fight. I hope it's a knockout. They've got 10 ounce on, so I hope it's a good fight.
Fantastic. It's been a pleasure speaking to you, Callum. All the best. Take care.